How to use Calendly for beginners step-by-step tutorial. Hi there, you guys. In this video, I will be talking about Calendly right here and how you can start scheduling using this platform. Well, basically, if you want to start using Calendly or if you want to give it a try, just head on to calendly.com and then you'll have to create an account using any emailing platform that you have. It can either be your Apple account, your Gmail, or any emailing platform, actually. And then once you're in, this is how the dashboard is going to look like. You can see here tools such as home, availability, integrations, help, of course, your profile and your account. So this is where you check out your account settings and their stuff, among other else. Okay, so first thing that you have to make sure is, are you integrated with the right applications that you and your workmates use, right? Before you actually schedule anything, make sure to check your integrations right here and then see if your applications are properly integrated. So think about the softwares that you and your workmates usually use. Do you usually meet on Zoom? Then go ahead and click on Zoom and then connect to Zoom. Now, for you to use this app properly, you'll have to integrate. That's why we're doing this first. Okay, so you sign in to your Zoom, sign in using the account that you used, and let me just go ahead and do that. Okay, and now let's authorize, allow this app to use my shared access permissions, authorize. Okay, so it says you're unable to install this app because it needs approval. Authorize. Okay, it's not really, how do we do this? Once you contact your Zoom admin for why is it not connecting, then it's gonna be smooth as butter. But anyway, let's go back to all the integrations and check out what other apps can we actually integrate. Okay, so this one's still on Zoom. All right, so we also have integrations for LinkedIn, for Salesforce, for HubSpot, for MailChimp, for Microsoft Teams conferencing, for WebEx, for Google Meet, for GoToMeeting, for Slack, for Gmail, for workflows, among other else. A lot more apps to choose from, but these are the apps only available. I'm not sure if there are already a lot of these, but I think a couple only. But let me just go ahead for Calendly for Chrome. Okay, I'm just going to go ahead and add this one to Chrome. And I'm going to just go ahead and add extension. All right. And we're going to go ahead and check out what the extension can do as well. Calendly for Chrome, it actually downloads the extension, you guys. That's it. All right. So the extension is basically like a small dashboard of your Calendly account. So no matter where you are, or no matter what tab, you can actually see the Calendly extension right over here on this. Now let's try and head on to home and create a new meeting or a new schedule. Now to create a new schedule, hit on new event type. And then create new event type. So is it going to be one-on-one? Is it going to be a group meeting? So let's create this one's going to be a group meeting. And this is where you set up the details of the event. So set up your event name. So I'm going to go ahead with maybe orientation for this one. So I'm going to type in work orientation. And I'm going to go ahead and choose the location. So is it going to be an in-person meeting, a phone call, Google Meet, Zoom, Microsoft Teams, WebEx, GoToMeeting, or custom? Now I'm going to go ahead with Google Meet. There you go. I don't have to connect Google because, it's automatically connected to my Google account. That's why. Now, the description and instructions, you can write here what they need to do to join the meeting, or what they need to bring and stuff like that. Ready your personal testimonials, something like that. Just so there's something here. And the event link. All right, so how does this work, you guys? Event URL is the link you can share with your invites if you want them to bypass the pick event step on your Calendly page and go directly to the pick date and time step. So the event URL is circled in the sample below right here. We'll automatically generate an event URL for you if you don't specify one. So now they'll automatically do it. So let's not specify. Max invitees in a spot. How many people are you going to invite? 20. That's enough. Display remaining spots on booking page. Yes, of course. This lets other people know if there, you know, are spots available. Hit on next. And then what you can do now here is to set up this next part, which is the date, basically. So when can people book this event? So the date range, 60 calendar days is too long. I'm going to go with maybe 15. 15. Okay. With the duration, we can go ahead and choose up until 60 from this, but you can also do a custom. So I'm gonna go with 60. And how do you want to offer your availability for this event type? Set custom hours or use an existing schedule? Working hours, yeah, I'm gonna go ahead with my working hour schedule. Or you can choose other schedules if you have them here on Calendly, you know, or if you have imported them from a different calendar. And of course, the weekly hours. This is where you set up your available time. Or the available, yeah. Right here. And then want to add time before or after your events. Before event or after event, it's really up to you. I'm going to go with after event. Now, you can check this out if you want additional rules for your availability. But you can just go ahead and skip it. Next one is additional options such as invitee questions, workflows, notifications and cancellation policy, confirmation page, and collect payments if there's going to be like a payment for the event that you're setting up. Okay. Next is add group event type. Yeah, I mean, this is what we're doing, right? So now we're done. Work orientation is ready to accept events. So this is the link. Now let's view it on let's view the page live. Okay, now let's check out this link as well. All right. So when they check out the link, you guys, this is what they can actually see. Right? Now select a date and time. Work orientation for 1 hour. So we set up 15 days or 2 weeks. So as you can see here, we only have days available 10. Because out of 2 weeks, we only work for 10 days, right? So now when people click on the link, this is what they'll see. So this is what you set up as your available time, right? But you can always edit that here. You can just go back and then try to edit what your availability is. And then this will basically change. All right. So once you click on a day, you can see here time that they can actually book 9 a.m. until 4 p.m. So 20 spots within 30 minutes. You can always change those up right over here. Work orientation, click that on, and then you can edit this part right there. So that's it, you guys. That's basically like a rundown of Calendly. Let me know what you think down in the comments below. If it's worth a try, or you can just use pen and paper or your classic phone calendar, right? So that's it for this video, you guys. I'll see you again on the next one. Peace out.